Hello! In this video, we're going to learn how to use JSP expressions. So, in JSP, there's actually different types of scripting elements. There's three, actually. JSP expressions, JSP scriptlets, and declarations. Now, what we'll do is we'll actually have a deep dive on each one of these topics in separate videos, but I wanted to give you just an overview real quick. So, a JSP expression is basically a small Java expression that you can include in the page. The syntax is angle bracket percent with an equal symbol, and we'll see a lot of that in this video. There's also what we call a JSP scriptlet. So a JSP scriptlet is simply an angle bracket percent, and then you add some Java code. You can add one to many lines of Java code, and we'll see that in the following video. And then finally, there's a JSP declaration. So this is angle bracket percent with an exclamation point. And so here you can define a Java variable or method. And again, we'll do a deep dive on that. So this next slide here is on JSP expressions. So basically you can compute some type of expression and the result of that is included in the HTML page that's returned to the browser. And so here's an example, and we saw this from one of our previous videos, actually the previous Hello World video. In your JSP file, you can say the time on the server is, and then you can add an expression. So again, remember, angle bracket percent with an equal symbol, and we can place a Java object there. Once this is processed by the server, then the generated HTML is simply the two-string version of that given date object. But let's take a look at some more examples of using JSP expressions. So in this next example, I'm going to show you how we can convert a string. So here I have this new string, hello world, and then I can say dot to uppercase. So I'm going to basically convert this string to all caps or to all uppercase, and the result of that will be included right here in the page. So that's for like strings and objects. You can also make use of mathematical expressions. So here I can multiply a value, 25 times 4 equals, and you can put any math expression in there that you'd like. You can also have Boolean expressions. So here I could say, is 75 less than 69? And it'll give me a value of true or false. And that's an example here of using JSP expressions. So we saw objects, mathematical expressions, and also Boolean expressions. Okay, great. So let's move into Eclipse and let's try this stuff out. I'd like to continue to use the same project from the previous video, JSP Demo. I'd like to move down to my web content folder. And what I want to do here is actually create a new file. So I'll just right click, I'll say new file. And for the name of this file, I'll simply call it expressiontests.jsp. And once you're happy with that file name, you can go ahead and click the finish button. Okay, great. So we have a very basic file here, actually an empty file, and we need to add something in it. So let's go ahead and start off with our basic HTML. I'll set up my body tag. And now I'll go ahead and type out that first bit of converting a string to uppercase. And now what I'd like to do is add a JSP expression. So again, angle bracket percent. And so here I say new string, hello world. And I do a dot, and I get the code completion here, and I'll say dot to uppercase. I'll select that item there. It's kind of cool. Eclipse can kind of help you out with some of the code completion there in a JSP file. All right, so that's it. So that's the file. I can go ahead and save it. And what I'd like to do is go ahead and run this file. So I'll just do a right click. I'll say run as, and then I'll choose run on server. All right, so this will start up my Tomcat server if it's not running already. And then right here in the browser, it'll give us the result, converting a string to uppercase. And remember, we had hello world as normal case, and now this basically converted hello world to all uppercase. So that's the result of our JSP expression running, which is really cool. All right, so let's take this a little bit further. I'm just going to add some line breaks in here. And now I want to do an example using a mathematical expression here. So here I'll say 25 multiplied by 4 equals, and now again, I'll make use of my JSP expression, angle bracket percent with an equal symbol, 25 times 4. So the result of this, of course, is 100, right? And the value of 100 will be included right there. So I simply save the file. So now here I can simply go back to my browser. I don't have to run it again. All I have to do is simply reload this page and the results will show up. So I simply hit the reload or the refresh button here. And there it is. 25 multiplied by 4 equals 100. Mission accomplished. Very good. So again, a nice thing here with JSP, if you make any changes to the file, you don't have to rerun it or redeploy it. You simply just reload that page and you're ready to go. Okay, let's do one more thing. Let's play around with Boolean expressions. So let me just move down here, add a line break. Let me just add some extra white space here just so we can see everything. And now I'll just have a very basic Boolean expression example. Is 75 less than 69? And now I'll let Java compute this for me. Again, very trivial, right? But we're just showing you an example here of a Boolean expression. So 75 less than 69. This will evaluate as true or false. Of course, we know this will return false, right? But we'll see how the JSP program will help us out with this. All right, so I'll save the file here. I'll move back over to the browser. And again, all I have to do is just reload or refresh. And then there it is. Is 75 less than 69? False. So very good. So we saw a really good example there of using JSP expressions for Booleans, also for math and also for string objects. All right, so let's go ahead and wrap up this video. We did a deep dive on JSP expressions. I showed you different types of expressions using objects, math expressions, and also Boolean expressions. In the following videos, we'll dive into JSP scriptlets, and we'll also dive into JSP declarations. So stay tuned. I'll see you there.